Hello everyone and welcome to this video tutorial of login by username module. In this video, I'll explain you the process to configure the module and I'll also show you how you can offer your customers to login via username instead of their email ID. So let's just head to the configuration part of the module directly. On the configuration page, you will find that there are two options. I'll explain you the significance of each option one by one. In order to make you understand of functions of each of these options, I'll first explain you what does this second option do. Then after, I will explain you the significance of first option. The second option allows you to show or hide suggestions for username to the customer while he is registering on your shop. In case if any guest wants to register as customer while checkout for any product, then at that page also you will be showing suggestions for username to that guest if you enable this option. The first option is whether you want to keep this username mandatory or not. In case if you enable this option, then a customer has the option to log in via any of the medium, either through email or ID and password or username and password. So this was all about the configuration of the module. Now let's just go to the front end of the shop. Now as you can see that no customer is logged into the shop. So let's just go to register on the shop. As you can see that this is the customer registration page, and here suggestions for the username are automatically shown. But later in the video you will notice that as I fill these details, that is first name, last name, email and other details, these suggestions will be automatically modified on the basis of the details filled by me. So let's just quickly fill these details. Now you can see that the suggestions have been changed. For your information, I want to tell you that the suggestions are basically shown on the basis of three details, that is first name, last name and your date of birth. The suggestions are basically the combinations of all these. To proceed to register, you can either fill your custom username, whatever you want to keep, or either you can choose one from the suggestions. As I have chosen one from the suggestions, now here the field has been filled by the chosen selected suggestion. Now just let's just register. Another thing, in case if you don't select from the suggested usernames and if you want to keep your custom username, then a message will also be shown that whether this username is available or not, or it is taken by any other person. As you can see, as I have selected from the suggestions and the username is available, that this means that it is not taken by any other customer on the shop. Now I have successfully registered on the shop. Now let's just sign out to see how this sign in via username works. Now as you can see that using username and the password which I have kept at the time of registration, I can now easily log into my account on the shop. And similarly, you can also allow your customers to select a username at the time of registering on the shop so that they need not to fill email ID every time while logging in to the their customer account on the shop. There is another functionality of guests too. In that case, if a guest wants to order some product without registering on the shop, then they get an option to create an account at that time. Then they can choose a username too at the time of creating an account and ordering as a guest. Let's just see how. Here, if I want to order this product as a guest, and along with that, if I also want to create an account at the same time, then there is an option of username too. In case if I want to order this product as a guest and I am also creating an account at the same time, then I can choose a username and I will be registered on the shop successfully with that username. And in case if I come further in time, and then I can simply log in via that username and the password. This was all about the front end. Now let's just see how an admin can see what username has been chosen by customers or what username are selected by customers. To do so, go to the customer section. In the customer section, there is another field added in the list of customers, that is username. Here you can easily see whatever the username has been chosen by customer. If you want to add new customer from your end, then an option to choose a username for the customer is also shown here, and you can simply select a username from the suggestions or you can choose a custom one too. Same functionality is available at admin's end too, that was available at customer end. So this was all about the login by username module. I hope this video will help you to configure the module in best possible way. Thank you.